Hi everyone, Aaron here for Zolotech, and iOS 15 brings quite a few small changes and refinements, but one of the bigger changes is Safari. And so I wanted to go over some of the new features, since Apple keeps changing this around, and see what you think about it. Do you love it? Is it an improvement, or is it something you think they should still change? Now, with the most recent betas of iOS 15, they've changed it around again, and I've shown this in the What's New video that I did, but here is Safari. And the first thing is the start page. You have a start page now in Safari with iOS 15. And as you can see, I have the same wallpaper that I have on my home screen. This is fully customizable in iOS 15. So if you're on the start page, you have no other pages open, you can tap on Edit, scroll down and set a background image of your liking. So you can pick anything that's here. These are all default wallpapers. And then you can pick your own in the upper left if you'd like to do that. With the start page, you can also include quite a few different things. So you can choose to use the start page or not use it at all. Apple is giving quite a bit of customization that we haven't seen in the past. You also have your option to show your favorites, your frequently visited, shared with you, privacy report, let's turn that one on, Siri suggestions, reading list, and iCloud tabs. So if we want all of those on, we can customize whatever we want. We can also tap and hold and move them around in the order that we want. So if we press and hold on the three lines here, we want these at the top, and let's go back. Now you can see here's a reading list. Some of these are a bit dated, but as you can see, and then there's also a privacy report now at the bottom. If I tap on the privacy report, it will give me more information about different websites that might be using my information or that it's prevented. So as you can see, 180 trackers have been prevented and 67% of the websites had trackers. So it's blocked some of those and let me know what's going on. So you can see there's quite a few different trackers, what they are. You can pick whatever website you'd like and see it there. You also have the option to use Apple's new private relay option, which will hide additional information. This tends to be very buggy during the betas, but will be much better once it's finished. Now, as Apple continues to refine the search bar or address bar on the bottom, they've made some changes to it. You can see right away, if you're not on a website, you'll have the option to just type in here and search, or you can use the microphone to search for what you'd like. So if we tap on the microphone, apple.com. You'll see in real time, it brings us there. I don't have to end it or anything like that. So it will bring us there. Once we're on that site, we don't have the option to search again with that microphone, but we do have the two A's similar to what we have with iOS 14. So if we're on a similar website, we've got those two A's in the upper left. Now, the most controversial thing about the address bar is that it's at the bottom, but Apple has given us the option to change this. So if we tap on these two A's, and now you can see we have an option for show top address bar. If we switch it, now it looks very similar to what we have on iOS 14. So you've got much of the same sort of layout if this is what you're familiar with. This is something we haven't seen Apple do before with customization. So right now they're allowing you to fully customize Safari, and I think that is a phenomenal thing that we haven't seen in the past. Safari is probably the best browser, arguably, for iOS, since when you use something like Chrome or Firefox or other browsers, they're just skinned versions of Safari, as Apple does not allow the full code base to run on iOS. So you're basically using Safari in the background with a skinned version to look a little bit different. Now, that may be useful for things like Chrome and logging into your account, but it's nice to know that Safari seems to be working well these days. So now that we have it looking like iOS 14, we have much of the same sorts of options. Other than the show address bar at the bottom, we have the same exact options. So we have our privacy report, our website settings, and again, the option to show it at the bottom. So if you want to stick with what you're used to and familiar with, you can do that. If you like the new look, you can switch it back to the bottom. I actually like it at the bottom because it's easier to access with one hand. So that's something I really appreciate. Now they've changed the way a few things work as well. So we have our option to go to our different tabs, and we have tabs here. And now we can get to that by just swiping up, or we can tap on this button now. So it looks a little bit different than what we had before. So it's tiled instead of sort of fanned in a card style like we have on iOS 14. Now, another thing that we have that's different from the previous versions is tab groups. So if we swipe up, you'll see this one says Apple because I have an Apple tab group. I can go to a different one and it recalls what might or might not have been there. I can swipe it off the screen if there's any open tabs. This is just the start screen, so you're not going to see that. But maybe we'll go to Apple and maybe we want to open another tab. So we'll open something else and maybe we'll just go to Google. And within this same tab group, we can switch between our two websites, but we can go back out and switch to maybe the other two tabs. Now those other tabs are open. So it's a little bit confusing. You can swipe them off the screen, but you have tab groups, which are separate from what we have with just general tabs. So again, this is more for if you want to research something, you want to have a set of tabs that you use normally for your work. Maybe you need Google and you need Google Docs, or maybe you need Microsoft products and you're on those websites. You can create tab groups, not only on iOS, but iPadOS and macOS as well. Now we can add another if we'd like to, and we'll just add another Apple tab just so I can show you. But again, if I swipe up, now we have three different ones. If I tap on done and then go back, you can see all of the different tabs that are open in this tab group. If I want to go out of that tab group, tap on what I've created at the bottom and then go back to your main one. It's a little bit confusing at first, but once you have it, it's sort of a power tool again to save all of those things that you have. Of course, you have your bookmarks. If we go into bookmarks, you've got your bookmarks, reading lists, and recent, and it just shows from the bottom and slides up, and you can show things that have been unread as well, or you could edit the list if you don't want to use them. Now, in addition to all of the different settings that I've shown you or different features within Safari itself, there's more under settings. So if you go into your settings and you go down to Safari, you'll see that we have similar search engine options like we had in iOS 14. But if we scroll down, you'll see that we have tab bar and single tab. Switching between these does the same sort of thing by moving the address bar from the bottom to the top. So if we move it to the top here under single tab, go to Safari, you'll see it's at the top. If we go back, go to tab bar, go back into Safari, now it's at the bottom. So it moves it that way if it's not as obvious through Safari itself. We also have the option for landscape tab bar, I'll show you in a moment, as well as website tinting. While this seems to work sometimes, it does not work all of the time. And what it does is allow different websites to sort of tint the address bar based on the color of the website itself. So if it's blue, the address bar will be sort of blue. Also, you have open links and closed tabs, so you can change these options as well. Apple is giving us more and more customization. And so if we go into Safari and maybe we rotate to the side, you'll see if we scroll down here, you've got your address bar. However, if we go into maybe different tabs, we'll go into the one we created earlier. We have three different tabs open, and now we have a tab bar across the top where we can go into all of them if we're in landscape. So this is something that's a little bit different, and we have the option to turn this off if we'd like to. So what we're seeing with Safari this year is more and more customization. This is not typical of Apple, where they give you the option. They tend to figure out what's best for them and best for you, and then implement that into the update. This time around, they're giving us additional customization we haven't seen in the past. And I think this is the right move because I prefer this on the bottom with the address bar, but a lot of people prefer the old style at the top. I like the one-handed use, and to see Apple give us the option of this is something that I haven't seen in iOS for, I think, ever or quite some time. And so I wanted to know what you think about this overall. Do you like what Apple's doing with Safari? Is it a huge change for you? Do you like that they've given us the option, or do you wish they'd revert it back to a previous version with maybe iOS 15's first beta where it looked a little bit different? And so with these different iterations that we're seeing, I think Apple's making the right move, listening to the customer, but I'd love to hear from you in the comments below. I'm glad they're doing it. I like the tab groups, and I like that it's easy to access general settings and more right from within the app, as we have individual website settings as well with request desktop website, use the reader automatically, and you can do different things such as allow Apple.com to access different things such as the camera, microphone, and location. We had this before, but now it's easier to get to, and I think it will benefit a lot of people, especially if you're using the phone one-handed, where you can just swipe up, swipe things off the screen if you want. So I think this is an advantage, but again, let me know what you think in the comments below. If you'd like to get your hands on the wallpaper I have in this video, of course, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.